stage, I'm not depressed. Thank you so much for attending today's press briefing, which has been called by the Trinidad and Tobago Football Association to announce the 24-man roster national senior men's team for the upcoming World Cup qualifiers against Guatemala and the United States, slated for September 2nd, right here in the Open Stadium. Kickoff 7:06 p.m. and then we travel to Jacksonville, Florida for that game against the United States. With me here at the head is our head coach, Stephen Hart, no stranger to any of us. He has finalized his 24-man squad, which I will announce in maybe a few seconds or so. But just before that, we just want to ensure that you all understand that the squad coming together for the first time, this actual squad under Captain Kevin Jones, for the first time since the previous World Cup qualifier against the Vietnam Redskins way back in March, as coach said. Just a few minutes ago, it seems like such a long time ago, but it actually took place this year, 2016. So allow me to announce the 24-man squad. We start with goalkeepers Marvin Phillip, Greg Ranjit Singh, Adrian Fonset, defenders Aubrey David, Radanfa Abubakar, Sheldon Batu, Carlisle Mitchell, Daniel Cyrus, Johansi Marshall, Mikel Williams, and Jovin Jones. The midfielders, the midfielders, Andre Bukar, Peter Hector, John Buster, Levi Garcia, Kevin Molino, Kaleem Highland, Nival Hackshaw, Jomar Williams, and then we complete the squad with the likes of Trevin Caesar, Shadon Winchester, Kevan George, Cordell Cato, and our national senior men's team captain, Kevin Jones. The squad will be handed out to you at the end of today's briefing. And right away, we continue by giving Coach Hart an opportunity to give his remarks on the selection and we'll open the floor to questions. Coach Hart.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everybody. The selection was one that had some complications in it, obviously. Mainly because, as you know, a number of our players have been inactive for a very, very long time because the Pro League is not in operation. And of course, the situation because I anticipate the question with Jan Michael, who is still in his recovery mode. He has said to me that he thinks he's 100%, but he has not played any football for a very, very long time. And it was probably one of the most difficult decisions to not include him in the squad. Other than that, I try to go with as much as possible of a squad that is playing and playing consistently.
Right, so just before we take questions, I think we'll just include that basically the newcomer to the team is the goalkeeper, Greg Ranjit Singh, who plays in the USL division in the United States. He plays for the Louisville City FC. He is a newcomer to the team, and allow me to again go through the squad very quickly. Marvin Phillip, Greg Ranjit Singh, Adrian Fonset, Aubrey David, Radanfa Abubakar, Sheldon Batu, Carlisle Mitchell, Daniel Cyrus, Johansi Marshall, Mikel Williams, Jovin Jones, Andre Boku, Hilton Hector, John Buster, Levi Garcia, Kevin Molino, Kaleem Highland, Nival Hackshaw, Jomar Williams, Trevin Caesar, Shadon Winchester, Kevan George, Cordell Cato, and Kevin Jones. So open questions for the coach. Can I show of hands, please?
Yeah, in terms of this goalkeeping situation, how important is experience as compared to actually practical play on the field?
Well, I think experience goes a long way, but at the end of the day, you need to be playing, you need to be sharp like anybody else, and you know with goalkeepers, it's a difficult situation when you are not really playing consistently and coming off of an injury that has not been tested. Okay? So I had to weigh all those factors.
Coach, I don't know if you could help us understand a little bit more the profile of this grand keeper. Is he US born or something like that?
Canadian born. I have had him scouted quite extensively. He's been having a very, very consistent season. and I thought it would be an opportunity for him to come in to work with Michael Maurice, and of course to push for selection within the squad.
One of the stars, this guy was not in your team. The situation with him, so
okay, the situation with Bostock is there's ongoing. There has been ongoing dialogue between the president and FIFA. The president has been persistent in his push to get the situation clarified, and we are almost 100% sure that the situation should be resolved by Monday. The people that were involved in FIFA, it was a bit of a setback because apparently there was people on vacation or whatever, but all the documentation and dialogue has been ongoing for weeks now.
Would you say though that it's a repeat of the situation before with John, of having him travel here without necessarily being verified as a cheap player?
Okay. If it turns out in the negative, yes. But the situation, all indications are, is that it should be resolved by Monday. And if I wait till Monday, it would mean John is not in a situation where he can train or be part of the team. So I'd rather take the chance leaning towards it being official, be made official before the game and he's here. If it's not something that's in my control. So if it works out in the negative, I have no control over that. I have to put my squad. And that's kind of the reason I went to 24.
I see that Kevin George is back. Have we missed this work rate in the past? We know that he's a very hard worker. Is that the only reason why he may be working back?
Well, he's playing. Mm-hmm. And he's played, I think, every game for his club. He's playing consistently. And he gives the midfield a different dynamic. It gives me an option that I don't have at the moment. So it's a matter of having someone that can give the midfield a different dynamic.